Oh my God, they're standing out in front of her mother's house making another fuss. They just love to do this. These people have spent so much time and so much of other people's money trying to attract attention and get the most money on TV. And they're thinking about suing, but their attorney isn't sure if they'd have a case. If you have an attorney that can't figure this out, what are you doing? Why, you're going to have to fire that attorney because he doesn't know what he's doing. These two are public figures. When they started courting CNN, ABC, CBS to go on to their various shows, they forfeited their right to privacy. But don't let that bother you. I would like to just point out something here. Judge Strickland ordered the entire family to have go for lie detector tests and also have their DNA. You know, he didn't order the lie detector test. I didn't mean that. He ordered DNA tests to be done. And then for the results to go back to the court. Well, they notified, or they told Lee that he was not, there was no match with him as far as DNA, and he could not, he is not the father. And of course, Cindy's was put in there as a control. But George's results was never given back to him or to his attorney or to the public. About he is, you know, the results, his results are still, as far as I know, under lock and key. So I don't want you to forget about that. Casey said she told psychiatrists and that she admitted that he had raped her for over many years, and starting at the age of, say, 9, I think it was. And I'm not really very keen on pedophilia. I have no sympathy for them at all. So don't forget this, George. I'm not forgetting it.